Here we want to look at how we handle the case of writing the mass balances for a batch reactor where we have reversible reactions. So isothermal reactor and the reaction A goes to B and then B goes to C, and both reactions are reversible, so I've indicated the four rate constants. They're all first order just to make it easy, and the question is, what do the mass balances look like for each of the components? Often we substitute these mass balances into some numerical integrator. First, let's write for component A. How is the number of moles in the reactor? So N sub A is the number of moles in the reactor as a function of time. How does it change for this reaction system? So A is going to be reacting to form B by this first reaction. And we have the rate constant. And we have the negative sign because A is being used up. And then B is going to react in reverse reaction to form A. These are all first order. And we can write similar equations for component C, because C is going to form from B, so K3 with the plus sign, concentration of B times volume, and C is going to react in the reverse reaction, so a minus sign. And then the final one for component B, how does its number of moles in the reactor change? So we form B in the first reaction, so a positive sign, K1, and then the reverse reaction, B reacts. B also reacts by the second reaction, so K3, concentration of B times volume. And then the reverse reaction, positive sign, K4, concentration of C times volume. So we have three equations. In this case, we have three unknowns, namely NA, NB, NC. If we fix the time, then we should be able to determine those, because we also take advantage of the fact we can write CA times V is equal to NA, and CB times V as NB, CC times V as NC. And of course, to actually do the solution, we need to integrate as a function of time. We need at t equals 0 the number of moles of A, the number of moles of B, and the number of moles of C in our system.